This is installing custom ROM on Android devices in 2023. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Lineage OS on your device. Lineage OS is a popular Android custom ROM built on the Android open source project supporting over 100 plus Android devices. It's particularly valuable for older devices that no longer receive official manufacturer support. Lineage OS provides security updates to address known vulnerabilities and also allows you to experience the latest Android updates. Before we begin, let's go over the requirements for installing Lineage OS on your Android device. You need a compatible Android device or tablet. You can verify if your device is supported by visiting the Lineage OS website. For this demonstration, I will be using the Nothing Phone 1 to set up Lineage OS. A computer running Windows, Mac OS, or Linux is required, a USB cable to connect your device to the computer, and lastly, you need an internet connection. Now, it's highly recommended to back up your important data such as photos and videos from your Android device before installing Lineage OS. Now, everything on your smartphone will be erased to install a fresh copy of the Android open source ROM. Also, make sure to update your device to the latest firmware before setting up Lineage OS. Now, let's proceed to install ADB and FastBit commands on your computer. Head over to this website and download the platform tools for your computer. In my case, I'm using Windows 11, so I will download the corresponding version. Once downloaded, double-click on the zip file and extract it to the C drive. Now, within this folder, you will find the ADB and FastBoot commands. Now, let's add this path to the system environment to access them from anywhere. To do so, highlight the address bar, then type env in the search bar, and click on Edit System Variables. Now select the path option and click on Edit, create a new variable and paste the path. Now type the ADB version inside the command prompt. It should display the information about the command indicating that the path has been added successfully. Next up, go to your web browser and download the Google USB driver. Once downloaded, extract it to your computer. Now, on your computer, head over to the About page and tap on the build number 7 times to activate developer settings. Then navigate to the developer settings and enable OEM unlocking and USB debugging. Now connect your device to the computer via the USB data cable. If you see a prompt, choose to allow debugging mode. Now on your Windows computer, open the command prompt or Windows terminal and enter the command ADB space devices. You should see your device listed. Now type this command to reboot your device to the FastBoot bootloader. Then type FastBoot devices. If it fails to recognize your device, open the search bar and search for Device Manager and open it. Now right-click on the Android under the Other Devices and update the driver. Follow the on-screen instructions to set up the Google USB driver. Now when you type fastboot devices, you should see your device is recognized. Now type this command to unlock the bootloader. After executing this command, use the volume keys on your device to select unlock the bootloader and press the power button to confirm. Your bootloader is now successfully unlocked. Now your phone will restart the stock ROM. Now on your computer, go to the official Lineage OS website. Click on Get Lineage OS and search for your device. I will be using the Nothing Phone 1 as an example. Now click on the link to download the necessary files. At the time of recording this video, Lineage OS 20 based on Android 13 is the latest available build. Now download the Lineage OS zip file, boot and vendor image files and place them into a folder for easier navigation. You can also refer to the installation instructions for your specific device to download the required files. Now that we have unlocked the bootloader, it's time to flash additional partitions. Now navigate to the directory where you placed all the files in the command prompt. Then on your Android device, go to the About page and tap on Build Number 7 times to activate the developer settings. Enable USB debugging in the developer settings and make sure your device is connected to the computer. Now open the installation instructions for your device and keep them next to the command prompt. Now type this command to reboot your device into the fastboot bootloader. Now type fastboot devices to make sure that your device is recognized. Next, enter this command to flash the vendor image. Finally, I'm going to type this command to flash the Lineage OS recovery. Now after that, type this command to reboot into new recovery mode. It's time to install Lineage OS. Choose Factory Reset using the volume keys and press the power button. Now select Format Data and press the power button to factory reset the device. Now this will also disable device encryption. Now once done, go back to the main menu. Select Apply Update and choose Apply from ADB. Now enter the command adb space sideload and select the Lineage OS zip file, then press enter to flash it. Now this will take approximately 10 minutes. Sit back, relax, and please be patient. Now for some time, you may see a message saying no error, even if it's stuck at 47%. Don't worry, the Lineage OS installation was successful. Now at this point, you will see a screen on your device that allows you to flash the additional packages such as Google applications. Now if you don't want to install GApp, select No to reboot into Lineage OS. For those who want to install Google applications, choose Yes. Now go to this link and download the latest GApps package. Since I have installed Lineage OS 20 based on Android 13, I'm going to choose this package, then place the zip file where Lineage OS is located on your computer. Then on your Android device, choose Apply Update and Apply from ADB. In the command prompt, run this command to set up gapps. You may see a signature verification fail message on your device. Simply choose yes to finish sideloading gapps. Now choose reboot to start your device into Lineage OS. As you can see, Google Play Store is now installed. And that's it. This is how you install Lineage OS on any compatible Android device. Please check the description for more information. And don't forget to read the official Lineage OS installation instructions for your specific Android device. If you have any questions or queries, feel free to post them in the comment section down below. I will try to answer your comments. Thanks for watching my video. This has been KS Kirail. I will see you in the next one.